Hello and welcome to Autoportal. Today here we have the all-new Toyota Camry Hybrid. Well, why I'm calling it all-new? Simply, it does seem that the old Camry went to Toyota's research silo and came back with an all-new makeover. But these changes are not just limited to its exterior. So without wasting any more time, let's get inside and find out what more changes are there on the interiors. Once you get inside the new Camry, the very first thing that you will notice is these well-cushioned ventilated seats. They not only offer the great support, but comfort as well. The support for the back and the lower back is good. The support for the under thigh is really good. And even the side bolsterings will hold you while pushing the cars through corners. Well, if you like the cabin of the outgoing Camry, you will simply fall in love with the cabin of the new Camry Hybrid. The new Camry Hybrid now feels more luxurious, and Toyota has worked really hard to keep up with the quality of the cabin that a luxury sedan should have. Like the soft plastic material used on the top of the dash and even the door pads are good. And even the Y design element on the center console adds more charm to it. If we talk about the features, there is an exhaustive list of features. Like you get an 8-inch touchscreen infotainment system with 9 JBL speakers, 10-inch heads-up display, wireless phone charger. Well, that's not all. It also gets 9 airbags, brake hold function, cruise control, sunroof, and many more. And if you really want to know more features, check out our website. There is a link below in the description. There is also a huge storage space under the center armrest, and you can also house those 1-liter bottles in the door bins. Well, coming to the rear seats, as you can see, there is loads of knee room, and even the headroom is massive. In terms of comfort, the rear seats are no less than the front seats, provided when you're offered with recliners.
The cushioning for the rear seats are great and also provides you with good and relaxed seating posture. You can seat 3 passengers with an ease, but no one will mind making it too comfortable with just 2 passengers at the rear, especially when you have armrests with touch controls in it. In terms of practicality, you get 2 cup holders just ahead of the center armrest touch control, and you can also house 1-liter bottles in the door bins. Coming to the boot, it is huge and can easily gulp big suitcases for those family getaways.
So here I am inside the new Toyota Camry Hybrid, and this car is built on Toyota's new global architecture. And this new platform has helped the car to come up with many other different changes. It is powered by 2.5-liter petrol engine. The new Camry Hybrid is built on Toyota's new global architecture, and it is this platform that has helped the car to come up with many different changes. It is powered by a 2.5-liter petrol engine that now makes 176 bhp of power and 221 Nm of torque, whereas the electric motor makes 118 bhp of power with 202 Nm of torque. Yes, there is a bump of power and torque figures in the petrol engine, whereas you will see the electric motor has been tuned down to some point or level. While in the case of the electric motor, it is totally opposite. It has been tuned down. Toyota has done this to match the power bands of the two systems, and in order to do, and moreover, to provide with a smooth ride, at the same time delivering a good power, making it more powerful and delivering a good fuel efficiency. Toyota has also provided with double wishbones at the rear in order to give you ride comfort for the rear passengers. Yes, it has improved ride quality. While going through the rough patches, the suspension setups can easily soak up all the bumps. Another change that TNGA platform has given to this, the new Camry now gets enhanced visibility. The bonnet has been dropped down by 40 mm. And moreover, if you compare the older model of the Camry, the A-pillars are more thicker in those.
The car now gives unhindered visibility. Even when you compare the A-pillar of the previous Camry, it was thicker compared to the one we are driving. So in the new Camry, it has been sleeked down, and even the side view mirrors have been repositioned more towards the door to give a better visibility and minimize the blind spots. The powertrain is paired with eCVT automatic transmission. You also get 3 drive modes: Eco, Normal and Sport. In this system, the car starts in an EV mode, and thereafter the petrol engine starts to take part in the process, giving a smooth ride. Even the gear shifts are smooth, and there is no sort of jerk feel as well. When putting this luxury sedan on sport mode, you hear thrumming noise of the engine. But that said, it is a luxury sedan and not a sports car. Pushing this car through the corners will simply stun you. It has very minimal body roll due to the lowered center of gravity given to it. The ride is smooth and comfortable, and this car can easily soak all bumpy rides, even rough patches, but to some extent.
It's been a while that Toyota has stepped into Go Green revolution since it launched the Camry Hybrid in the Indian market. But with the new Camry Hybrid, the game has gone way forward. It has stylish looks, luxurious interiors, along with that, a fuel-efficient hybrid engine, which is a great alternative to the diesel models out there in the market. And if you're worried about the maintenance cost, well, don't be. It has a Toyota badging on it. Goodbye for now and drive safely.